Hey YouTube, it's Matt with Oldest Reptiles, and I am here with Cody from Pride of Texas Pythons and Pride of Texas Racks, located in the great state of Louisiana. But we are talking about a way to get you back to Texas, right?
Yep.
You gotta buy these. It helps. You buy these, he helps to get back to Texas where his heart is. So let's help this guy out and get him home.
It's like GoFundMe with work.
Yeah, we were talking about Patreon about making like a flow chart like to get Cody back to Texas, like one of those fundraiser things. So watch for that if you're on Patreon. And if you're not on Patreon, you probably should be, because he's going to tell you all about this style of rack that he started to produce now. And remember, if you are on Patreon, you get 10% off of these. And there's also a military discount as well.
Correct.
Yep. So if you're military, you don't have to join Patreon to get the discount. They do not stack, so I'm not going to try to double sell you on some crap that ain't there. But we'd still love to have you anyway.
Military and law enforcement.
And law enforcement, that's right. Which is awesome, by the way. And I know somebody's going to be like, just shut up. It's for law enforcement. All right. So why don't you walk us through this rack and tell us about this one?
Yeah, so this is our FB5 hatchling rack. It's good for ball python-wise. Hatchlings to about, we'd say about 400 grams, maybe.
At the most, yeah.
At the most.
Yeah.
Then they're ready to move up. But it's great for breeders, you know, having stuff for shows and whatnot. We do all of our FB5s in this 15 tub configuration. When we sell a 30 tub, we also offer it for a 30 tub. But basically I've got it priced where the 30 tub is you buying two of these minus $50. So
yeah.
If you buy two, you're going to save $50 on it.
And it'll be a full stack then, right?
Right. And it'll come two separate ones. And I did that way you can either run them side by side or you can choose to stack them.
Gotcha.
So, and then these are 26 3/4 inches high, so they can stack three high.
So I was wondering, look at them, I was thinking, I bet I can get three of those high. Mm-hmm. Which, if you're running three high, that's, we got what, 15. That's 45 babies,
yeah,
right?
45.
So. That's a lot of babies, you know, so that's awesome. Because it's, think of when you're breeding, man, and I'll tell you guys, if you're just getting into it, and if you've been into it a while, you're going to be shaking your head as I say this. It's hard having enough space for all your babies. When you start producing a number of clutches, you start thinking, where am I going to put all these babies? And babies take up a ginormous amount of space in your reptile room. And then you're going to sell a lot of them, and you're going to have all this empty space. Like, fuck, I even using this. With these, you know, being able to cram 45 in a small space is really a good thing. Now, the tubs you're using, these are made by Freedom Breeder still, right?
Correct. Yeah, Freedom Breeder tubs. They got the ventilation and cup holders and...
Now, these are similar to the tubs that we were getting on the racks that we were getting from TGR where they made them, but this is a different construction. Their tubs were all Freedom Breeder except for on these. I don't think Freedom Breeder was making these tubs then.
No,
this
they
is a new design.
This
right.
Is, this is newer, yeah.
And, but with these being the Freedom Breeder, there are a thicker plastic and a stronger plastic. So, I mean, there's a lot of strength to that, which is really good because the other ones, they didn't have the strength because Freedom Breeder wasn't making them yet.
Yeah.
And obviously Freedom Breeder makes, you know, and they don't sponsor us or anything, but they make the best tub in the business.
Yeah.
I'm happy to tell you when somebody makes a damn good product, whether it's a sponsor or not, and Freedom Breeder is the best tub in the business. So
they do. They definitely do. And then the tubs too, these fit a little tighter than the other racks. The other racks I've designed to have just a little bit of space on the on the tub where the tub runners go. But with the lip being so narrow on there.
Right.
This is the way that it slides on the tracks. And I mean it doesn't come off the tracks that way. So it's scrunched
and
in there.
If people are wondering, well, don't I need ventilation space there? You don't, because
no,
all this.
Ventilation here.
So, you know, and there's going to be plenty of gap there for ventilation. And you don't want a ton of ventilation. You'll lose all your humidity if you have too much. So.
Yeah, and there's a little bit too. And these tubs are kind of bowed just because of the size of it. So when you have, you know, substrate in the weight of a snake in there, it's going to draw it down on the tub runners and it'll have that gap.
So it'll still be there anyway.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's look at the back of this. The back isn't on this one, correct?
Yeah, the back's not on it.
But that's going to let us kind of show you how this was ran. So one thing I noticed right away that I really, really like from previous types of these I've seen is previous types on these, what you would see is heat tape that would go through, then come out the side, curl back in, go through, come out, curl back in, where these are all separate wired pieces of heat tape, it appears, correct?
Correct.
So I like that. I think it's just a cleaner look. Again, you're running your dado cuts where the back is going to snap on here, fit. You can see this is already pretty solid. Doesn't have much give or shimmy. And when you put that back on there, it's going to be like a rock, which is
And then phenomenal. Same solid wire, 14-gauge solid wire. So, I mean, it stays. You can bend it and make it stay in place. So they're out of the way of the tubs. You don't have to worry about loose wires or nothing like that, or if you got a rat loose chewing through it and all that kind of
Yeah, because with the back on here, there's no spot for them to really get in to start wrecking havoc, which is a major thing, because those little bastards will certainly do that. And if you breed enough snakes and you breed rats, sometimes a rat gets loose. It's not fun. But having that, I mean, it's built to withstand a lot of that. Yeah. So again, just a really good design. So if you're looking for these racks, so you're doing FB5s, FB10s, right?
Yeah, do it FB10s. I've got it priced right now, I think, because we've got the Facebook page up.
Yeah.
We don't have a website up yet. And I'm pretty sure I've got the FB10s priced at a 10-tub rack. Mm-hmm. So stack two on each row. I can do
three,
yeah. though. It'll be the same design as this.
Yeah.
It won't be quite as tight because the FB10s are a little bit bigger lipped. And it'll be a little bit wider, the same height though, because these tubs are the same height on those 10s. So yeah. they can still
aren't they the same width? They're just longer, right?
They're less wide, same height, and I think same length.
Are they?
Because I think the length. Yeah, I'd have to check, but on the 10s, they'll still stack three high.
Okay.
So whether you have a 10 stack or a 15 stack, they'll stack three high on the 10s.
But you've got fives available now, 10s available, 20s, 40s, and 70s.
If anybody wants an 80 or 90, I can look at doing it, but it's going to take a little bit more time. So.
Which those would be more for if you were running boa tubs or if you were running
boas or bloods. Or,
you know, you can kind of do that. But two, you know, I know for my two bloods, no offense, but I'm going to probably avoid tubs long term and go to a display cage long term, because some of those animals you just want to be able to see. Like, it's just some things you just want to be able to see. And also, you know, maybe it's just me, but I have to open a blood tub. It still makes me go, oh, shit. Like, where's your head at? This is my cage. I can see it. But you have pretty much every size anybody can need now, ready to go and available. So you guys have now seen the 5s. We haven't shown a 10. We've seen the 40s, I believe. And then soon, we have a 70 that's coming soon, right? Yeah. So soon we'll be able to show you guys his FB70s. And it's going to all be a very similar design, but...
And I have pictures of everything up on the Facebook page too. So
yeah, and then I mean, everything's great. So is there anything that you've learned since the first time you came here and filmed that's changed on the rack design since then to now?
I mean, not really on the design. You know, just getting those first test ones out of the way and getting kind of a rhythm and everything like that. I mean, if you remember from those, the quality of it's a little bit better. Everything lines up a little bit better. You know, trying to get measurements worked out.
He says that, and I'll tell you guys something. So this is why I cannot build cages or racks, okay? Because we've got two people now doing this with us, and they're both anal perfectionists, and I mean that in a good way. Don't take that as an insult.
I lose sleep.
Because I look at the test racks we got, and I'm like, damn, these things are perfect. And Cody comes in like, well, there's this 1/8 of a millimeter overhang here that I should have done. I'm like, Jesus, what the fuck are you talking about? It's great. He's like, no, that's bothering me. I need to come. I'll come sand it. I'm like, just to stop. Don't worry about it. So when your cage builders and your rack builders are perfectionists, that's a really good thing. If I built one for you, it would probably work, but it'd be the most janky thing. It looked like some of a Dr. Seuss book. But yeah, everything is just perfect on here, you know, and you can see the cuts that are made. Again, everything's screwed together, so it makes it solid. It's just, man, this work blows me away. If you guys need a rack, you need a baby rack or an adult rack, and you wonder where to get it, I know there are several places you can go, and there are several quality racks out there. So this is not, I'm never going to sit there and say this is the only way to go. I mean, you got your ARS, you got your Freedom Breeder, and you've also got these. What I'm saying is take a look at these before you make a decision, because this may fit your needs better. There are some things about this that will beat the metal racks. And I know that's sacrilege to say in some circles. They're lighter, they're easier to move, they're easier to transport, they're easier to deal with on that front. This is gonna last forever. You don't have to worry about things catching fire. I know when these were first designed, the style, they were plugging the wall straight just to see if it would melt, and it never did. That's because it's lifted up off of the heat. Now, I don't recommend that. You'll still cook your animals, but you probably won't burn your house down. I say probably so you can't sue anybody if you burn your house down trying it. Don't do that. But they're very safe design. That's kind of what I'm getting at on that front. So they're really hard to beat. The other thing is you can buy a simple 5-stack. You can buy a 10. You can kind of piecemeal it together. You don't have to buy a whole bunch all at once. You don't have to deal with the big heavy metal and steel. I can tell you I've moved this material, I don't know how many times, and it's never broke. It's always held up. I've had it shipped. I know FedEx has managed to break it. But let's be honest, FedEx can break a diamond in half somehow. I don't know how they do it, but FedEx can break anything. But they can't. Sometimes I think they're playing bumper cars with that shit. I don't know what they do, but I've moved them. We've moved them multiple times, Kurt can tell you, and upstairs, downstairs, multiple houses, and we've never had an issue. So it's going to hold up on you. And that was ones that I don't think, truth be told, were built as solid. Like, these are solid.
So
definitely give it a look. One, it's probably going to save you a little bit of funding. And two, you can custom basically make your reptile room to fit what you need. And you can do it a piece at a time instead of one huge investment. And your lead times, you have lead times because orders are rolling in, right?
Yeah, I do. And that's one thing that's bugged me about all this. And it's a mix of things. But yeah, we were shooting for 4 weeks. On average, it's honestly getting to about 5 or 6 weeks.
Yep.
And it's just because of COVID and startup and trying to get stuff from vendors in and FedEx being
FedEx.
FedEx is horrible before, and then Corona hit, and FedEx is just horrible now.
It's like they have an excuse to be terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's great.
Between all that, it's, you know, and so far I've had really good customers, and anybody that's watching this video that's ordered a rack from me and you've waited for over to where I said it was going to be, really, thank you. That means a lot that y'all aren't being crazy on it. But
the thing is, that's still four to eight weeks, truth be told, is a pretty short lead time in this industry. Yeah, so, you know, well, you're not happy with that. What I'm telling you is that beats 95% of the stuff out there. Yeah. There's only one I can think of that does maybe as quick or quicker turnaround, and it is a completely different design that I personally, it's okay. It's okay.
It's good. I'm not going to dog anybody's racks. I like all the racks out there. I've pushed people to other companies. I've pushed people to, I don't know if I want to say it on video, but I've pushed people to other competitors' racks because they were wanting a little bit simpler design, a little bit more economy style rack.
Right.
And I'm okay saying, hey, look, it's, you know, this isn't what I do, but these are who's
we're talking about the same thing, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
And they're the only place I know that'd be slightly quicker. But everything else, you're usually looking at 12 weeks is pretty much industry standard. I've heard of 4 and 5 months at times. So what I guess I'm telling you as customers is try to plan a little early, no matter who you go with. But you're probably going to get, for a high-end rack like these, your quickest turnaround probably right here too. Now, that may not stay. As more orders come in, it could grow, it could shrink. It just depends on everything. But get your orders in, get them started, and let's get a rack. Bam. I'm just jealous because here's a secret. You guys are probably looking, thinking this is mine. This actually isn't my rack. This is a different customer's rack. This one actually belongs to Warehouse Exotics and Enclosures. I guess it's Warehouse Enclosures because, Warehouse Enclosures. So if you'll check them out, this is who this rack's going to. He's going to be on our Patreon video and talk about a way that he acquired this rack with two of those guys. So share another way you can do things in business. Anything else you want to add? If you missed something, now's your time to brag on yourself. Don't be shy.
Not that I can think of. I mean, it's been nice. We talked about earlier. It's been the most rewarding and fulfilling yet terrifying thing I've ever done.
So, how many hours a week you working, do you think?
Oh God, I don't even want to know. 7 o'clock to about 11 o'clock most nights at the shop.
Five-day work week?
No. Seven.
There you go.
It's definitely not what the schedule that I want to, but you know, I really am trying to get these out as soon as I can, as many as I can, and fulfill orders as you know.
It is a schedule on startup. And the one thing I want to let you guys know too, so when you are sitting there and you're going, why does it take 4 weeks? Well, part of us wait on that, and look how hard people are working to get that to you. So you got to keep that in mind and have a little patience sometimes, I know. But communication, I think, has been good with your customers, too.
It has.
I haven't had anybody tell me, you know, whenever we have some news advertisements and things like that, we hear a lot about it.
Yeah.
Good, bad. I hear both. I have not heard a single bad thing about communication, about what they got, about how it was packaged. Nothing. Not a single complaint. And that should tell you guys that if you want something, it's ready to go. Because you've already sent out quite a few racks, right?
Quite a few, yeah. There's quite a few more that I've still got to get done. So it's going.
If people were being angry, I would see it. And I have not. Not a peep.
Yeah.
Nothing but good. And it's harder to get a good comment than it is to get a bad comment. And I've heard nothing but good. So congratulations on that. I think you're doing wonderful work. I
appreciate it.
Kurt, anything you want to add?
No.
All right, guys, that's all I got. We'll see you next time. And soon we'll be showing you the FB70 version, which I can't wait to get in the house because, you know, I'm really digging these. So we'll see you next time.